Non-essential travel is officially welcome back in Hawaii next week as well, and we are giving you a preview of what to expect.
Dallis Ontiveros joins us live from the Daniel K. Inouye International Airport with all the details. Morning, Dallis.
Good morning, Christine Ross. That's right. That non-essential travel date is right around the corner, November 1st. And here to tell us more of an idea of what we can expect, we have our friend Mike McCartney, who's a DVET director. Good morning, Mike. Aloha.
Aloha.
Thanks for joining us here on Wake Up Today. We appreciate it. So let's talk about the overall readiness of our state and the different businesses. First, since we are here at the airport, have you spoken to any airlines and have they give you any feedback about the upcoming changes?
Yeah, we've been talking to a lot of employers, like our airlines. And I think the biggest challenge they're having now is making sure everybody gets vaccinated in accordance with the federal mandate. And like any business, they're wanting people to come back to work. And I think overall, nationwide, there is a challenge to find workers who want to come back to work. But I think locally, we've been doing a good job of getting people, and because I think people are ready and wanting to go back to work. The pandemic has been 18 months. And I kind of feel this pent-up feeling that it's time to go back to work. And so that's all starting, but the logistics of that are going to slow things down a little bit.
So that vaccination mandate is happening on December 8th?
Yeah, there's a federal mandate for all federal contractors to make sure, and airlines are part of that. So they're busy getting their employees vaccinated and ready for that.
Okay, so hopefully there's no shortage at all, and you know there's some sort of resolution or some sort of loopholes to keep our workers on that. But let's talk about hotels. What have they been telling you?
The hotels are excited about ramping up. We've also been meeting with the unions and to talk to them. And again, in any transition, there's a little gap between how many people want to work and how many people are available to work. But I think that that'll all straighten out once the flights start coming in and people start arriving. People have confidence that they can hire and spend more money to hire people, and then people coming back and getting the hours that they want. You know, people want to work full hours, not half hours.
Yeah.
And so all that matching is going to take place. Mm-hmm. So I think this next year is going to be a transition management issue, but I think it's a positive issue, not something that's negative, that trying to put people back to work in the right places to make things go and work.
Mike, you're still going to be hanging out with the next half hour talking about the overall readiness of the state before that November 1st date. So we appreciate your time.
No, I think we're really ready. We're moving from fearing the virus to learning how to respect it and live with it. And I think that's a great place that Hawaii's in right now.
All right. Well, let's open up. Okay. Reporting here from the scene, Dallis Ontiveros, KH12 News, working for Hawaii.